So they're putting all their trust in you, and you have to be a good friend and not lead them astray.
It's called the Meet a Tree Blindfolded Walk. The goal is to build trust in friends and nature, and to learn to appreciate the natural world in a new way. For example, have you ever taken the time to really touch and study a tree? Most tree bark is pretty rough, but the oak tree's bark is smoother than most.
Turn that way.
Do you stop sometimes to listen and look and see the flowers in the weeds, and then look closer still, or be still and listen again, and then look up and see what is calling to you? In this busy runaround world, the instructors at the Raleigh-based nonprofit Center for Human Earth Restoration teach adults and children to be like the bee. Take the time to take time and get out into nature. And these students are proof you can learn a lot about yourself and the earth in the classroom of nature.
This is a poem, but it doesn't have a title. Okay. Spot something in nature, stare at it in the light. I bet you didn't know that it looks so nice or shines so bright. See nature's beauty and nature's kind, no matter what perspective, in front or behind.
Nature is bright, nature is cool, and if it's not, then you're a fool. Trees are green trees, black bugs. No one is too good for mother's love.
Chilling out in the woods with the flies, mad flies, mad flies. It was so big I couldn't even tell. Mad flies, mad flies. I saw so many bugs I couldn't even tell by my eyes, my eyes.
The purpose for this innovative outdoor education program is to have adults and children not only see the land, but understand the land and enjoy it.
And our goal is to get youth and adults to be able to participate in nature through taking part in restoration ecology projects and also reflection and journaling activities that allow them to develop an environmental ethic. So we like to think that we put the heart of the experience of being in nature back into environmental education.
Instructors find that many participants have been outside on a playground or in a field, but they've never really been in the outdoors. Instructors strive for not only a learning experience, but a transformative experience.
I think it's an innate thing that all humans have, but we have to kind of remind ourselves that there's a great peace in nature and that there's a comfort we can all find there. With some of our kids, the first day of nature camp can be a shock with insects flying around and a cricket, really tickles on the skin, and that can really scare some kids. But once they get past that initial shock, there's an innate feeling of comfort and joy that comes out.
The experiences are wide-ranging. Eating peach cobbler cooked over an open fire. The cobbler didn't last long.
Now, to have a bird like this, you have to be a falconer.
Listening to a falconer explain his sport and seeing the majestic bird up close. Sandy, by the way, is a one-year-old hawk. Its eyes are 10 times better than a human's. Learning a Native American prayer that explains respect for the land.
We are one family. The fish, the bird, the wolf, and me.
Me.
Thank you.
And finding out how NC State forestry instructor Thomas Easley learned to love the outdoors in his grandmother's garden.
That the earth is ours and we took care of the earth at one time. We weren't afraid to go outdoors. A snake didn't scare us. An insect or a tick didn't scare us. We knew how to take care of ourselves and take care of the earth.
Conservationists and educators started the center in 2007 as a way to introduce a new style of environmental education. It first connects people to the planet, and then through that connection, teaches earth science, ecology, and environmental science. The classrooms are the lands in central North Carolina protected by the Triangle Land Conservancy. This is Temple Flat Rock Preserve in eastern Wake County.
There's a lot of sensitive environments here. You can see around us the flat rock. So it's, you know, there's lots of unique species when you look around. There's lots of neat mosses and ferns, and there's even some native cactus that grow on the flat rock. Well, I hope that they would find that these really unique environments are inviting, and that it's a great opportunity to see new plants or to, you know, meet new species that they may have not encountered before.
CHER has been doing environmental education programs with adults for years, but a couple years ago decided to expand into schools and then summer camps. The idea being it's easier to teach children about oak hickory forests and 400 million year old rocks when they're actually in the middle of it. The YMCA of Wake County, as well as Wake County schools, are some of the center's partners. These students are from the CHER Family YMCA in Wake Forest.
And that's the bigger thing. They get a deeper appreciation of what nature is and how we are an active part of that in taking care of it and learning more about it so that we can take care of it so the next generation can actually be appreciative of it as well. And we've seen that appreciation grow like from the beginning of the week, Monday, where everybody was, I mean, I'd say 90% of them were deathly afraid of all the bugs and all the outdoors. And now, this week, everyone's comfortable. They're actually enjoying it. And they've learned a lot throughout the course of the week.